How do I represent my lifecycle funnel in HubSpot? Here's how it works.
Superhacks, the HubSpot Experts. Presented by WPWA Digital.
First, we'll go through the different aspects of the lifecycle funnel. There are different objects and properties you should know. Starting with the object contact. When you click on a person's contact card, you get an overview of the different properties associated with it. Here on the left, you can see the lifecycle stage that is created by default in HubSpot. These stages are called, for example, lead, marketing qualified lead, MQL, sales qualified lead, SQL, opportunity, and customer. But you can also customize the stages according to your needs. These stages are relevant for marketing, sales, and service. You can also find the lead status of the contact here. This can be, for example, new, open, in progress, open deal, or unqualified. This lead status is mainly relevant for the sales team. Second, different deal stages. To do this, click on Deals under CRM. In your deal pipeline, you can see your specific sales opportunities based on their progress, and you can also customize the deal stages. Now we'll explain how you can align your lifecycle stages and lead status with the deal stages. HubSpot has some automation set up by default. When a deal is opened, HubSpot automatically sets the lifecycle stage to opportunity. When the deal is marked as one in the pipeline, HubSpot automatically sets the lifecycle stage to customer. When a contact fills out a form, the lifecycle stage is set to lead. You can also customize the form options. You can also determine for yourself which properties or criteria need to be met for. For example, the lifecycle stage MQL or SQL. You can do this best with workflows. To do this, go to Automation and select Workflows to create a new workflow. Then select a contact-based workflow. You can set the triggers for contacting based on your criteria. In this example, I specify that the property's job title and phone number must be known. Also, the contact should have the lifecycle stage lead beforehand. This way, I make sure that the contact goes through all the lifecycle stages, which is better for my reporting. For the next action, I choose to set property value and set the property lifecycle stage. For marketing qualified leads, the lifecycle phase MQL is automatically set for contacts that have the lifecycle phase lead and whose job title and phone number are known. You can apply the same principle in a new workflow for the lifecycle stage SQL. For that, you just need to adjust the recording triggers. Our tip, the sales team should think about what criteria need to be met to start a conversation with a contact. These properties should be created so that they can be used later in workflows. Do you like the video so far? Show us with a like. If you don't want to miss anything, subscribe to our channel and turn on the bell. Now it just needs to be aligned with the lead status. I recommend you think about which lead status should belong to which lifecycle or deal phase. Here's an example of how you can make the assignment. According to your structure, you can set up additional workflows. For that, you need a contact-based workflow. The recording trigger could be that the deal stage is any of qualified for purchase. Here you can then select the appropriate lead status, like for example, open deal. Alternatively, you can also flip the concept around. In this workflow, I specify that a certain lifecycle stage is set as soon as a specific lead status is reached. And that's it. Now your lifecycle funnel is perfectly harmonized. If you have more questions about it, feel free to write them in the comments or visit our website to arrange a personal conversation.